So I was on Reddit and I saw a post from a developer saying they had a frustrating experience with the Next.js App Router. I wanted to make a video response instead of text because I feel like in online communities like Reddit, where the discourse is primarily text-based, you can often lose a lot of the emotion and empathy for the developer. And I want to try to bring some of that back and have a healthy discussion about some of these things. Okay, so let me read the post and I'll stop along the way to explain things. So the post from Shoddy Salamander 5.5 is, the Next.js 13 app router has been a frustrating experience for me, and I'm really seeking someone to clarify its benefits. I'm having trouble seeing how it aligns with React's principles. Let's consider a scenario. You have a user profile page, and you want to implement it as a server component to have server-side rendering. You fetch the user data directly from the database inside of the component, and you display it as usual. Now, let's say the user has posts that you want to display on the page, and you introduce some client components for interactivity. However, you find it puzzling because there's no local state for posts to update. So any changes, like upvotes or adding posts, seem to require refetching the data altogether, which seems impractical. So let's break down a couple things here. The first one is on the naming of server components and client components. I often have been seeing this comparison of server components and server-side rendering. And it's tricky because one of those is the established term that everyone is familiar with, server-side rendering. What's tricky is that a client component is also rendered on the server. You get to use the client for interactivity. So sometimes the existing words don't actually help when you're trying to understand and compare that to this new additive model that's being added with server components. I really love Dan's diagram and explanation on why client components still get server rendered. And I'd recommend checking that out if you want to learn more. I'll put a link in the description. Now, let me continue reading and we can swing back and answer the part about data mutations like upvotes or adding new posts. So they continue, before I would be able to have state for a post, and adding posts would require a fetch post request and a state update. That's it. But if I want my page server-side rendered, the data on the page stays on the server and any client-side only components I bring in cannot interact with that data in any meaningful way. Compared to the previous approach in the Next.js pages directory, it was more efficient. The introduction of server components has led to these paradigm changes. Although writing a git server-side props function took a few extra minutes, it offered the benefit of server-side rendering for the entire page component. This allowed for the use of React hooks, making the page both SSR and interactive with the data. So this kind of goes back to the initial point of understanding the differences between server components and client components. You can kind of think of the Next.js pages router as effectively all client-side components. That means they're still being pre-rendered from the server, but they get to use the client. So the git server-side props function was the only part of the page that was exclusively running on the server. It was getting your data and it was passing it along. Now with this new additive model of server components, not only can you get your data, like in git server-side props, you can also produce HTML and have it run server only. I have a video below on incremental adoption into the app router where I show this pattern of effectively making git server-side props into a server component where all it does is just forward the data to a client component, basically one-to-one mapping the approach of the pages router. But then you could progressively add more UI to your server component, which is going to shift that JavaScript from being sent to the client side to remaining exclusively on the server side. Now, there's an interesting point at the end talking about how this allowed for the use of React hooks. There's an interesting mental model shift with the app router, which makes you kind of confront the difference between server and client components in development so that you're very intentional about where you actually want to use something that's interactive, whether it's using state or effects or other things that actually use the interactivity on the client. You might find that some of the places where you had that client-side state in React state, you can actually lift that state to the server and have it be closer to your database. So continuing on with the post, they say, although some may say that using server components is optional, I feel like it's somewhat forced upon developers. Next.js was initially built around server-side rendering functionality, but now the emphasis on server components for data fetching seems to limit interactivity with that data. So yeah, you kind of have to make the decision, do I want to fetch data on the server and have that be server only, or do I want to have parts of my UI take advantage of the client to do something that's interactive? I've heard about server actions, but it seems they're still in alpha, which adds to the frustration. Yeah, I think this is definitely true. I think it is challenging that there are parts of this model that are still being worked out that are exciting and they're interesting and you want to see how these things will work in practice, but they're not ready to fully adopt yet. We're working really hard to get those out of alpha or experimental and push them further along. But for now, I wouldn't recommend using them widely, but it's at least interesting to learn about them. Continuing on, React was made to build web applications, interactive web applications. What benefit does React server components, the way Next.js integrated them, benefit anyone besides blog sites that want to display their static or dynamic data super ultra fast? So I think it's true that React is great for making interactive applications, and the origins of React made it very easy to sprinkle into basically any website that you had. Now, 10 years later, with the growth of React, a lot of React developers also want to take their React knowledge and not only build apps and interactive web apps, but also sites. And maybe this distinction is, you know, not that meaningful, but mostly presentational content, mostly HTML, mostly templating. And for those type of things, they might actually not have that much interactivity, which is why server components can be a great alternative in this case, because you're still getting to write React code, you're still getting to use the skills that you already have, but effectively you're templating out React from the server. Okay, let's look at some of the comments. So the top comment, I think they rushed called a stable feature. It's far from it. This community can't wait a day to try the latest and shiniest. Keep using the Pages Router. It works well. Wait until next year when the App Router will be more stable. It's a fucking mess. And so on and so forth. The one part of this comment that I agree with is that the Pages Router continues to exist and will continue to be supported and even new features added. Hopefully we've conveyed that message that it's not like you need to necessarily move everything to the App Router today. It's the long-term vision for the framework. And there's, you know, many, 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 many applications using the Pages Router today that we absolutely want to make sure we're still helping support and bring on the journey as well too, and make their experience great. So if you're using the Pages Router, you don't have to move anything over today. More comments. I'm currently converting my boilerplate projects for Next.js 13. I'm not quite happy with how the app thing works. I might stick to the usual old one. I don't feel like it's worth it to do. I think that's totally okay. I would love to just use the Pages directory, but constant videos and documentation talking about how smooth transitioning it will be make me feel like the code base will be deprecated. So yeah, apologies if it's came off that way. Definitely don't want the Pages Router to feel like something that's deprecated. While we're giving you the option now to move into the App Router and the core APIs are stable, meaning, you know, we've pretty much agreed on how you're going to interact with this thing. We're trying to make it a great experience. You definitely don't need to build all of your apps with the App Router just yet. If they told me the Pages directory will always exist, I would, without a second doubt, go straight to it. Yeah, it'll still be there. Okay, more comments. Let's see, from Jazzy Moneymaker. SSR is overrated and mostly useless in interactive applications. Okay, it's cool to have blazing fast landing page, but try to handle complex business logic with it. So I think this sentiment is from folks who've been building a lot of client-side only React applications who are still trying to understand the value of the React application owning more of the server. And there's definitely going to be an archetype of app that is client-side only that remains that way. And I think that's totally fine. What React is doing now is starting to have a bit more of an opinion about how you should use the server and how the client and the server interact together. Because if you're building a client-side only application, all of a sudden you need to add authentication, you need to talk to a database. Well, now you need to use the server in some way. And the idea with server components is to make that journey a little bit easier. Here's another comment from Shoddy Salamander 595 talking about with the App Router, how is this even considered React anymore? It's a joke. You can't make this up. And all of the YouTuber shills love it. Oh no, I'm on YouTube. This is a problem. I think an interesting thing to consider here is that I actually feel like the App Router is more React than the Pages Router, because in the Pages Router, you had Next.js specific abstractions. So when you needed to learn about how to do data fetching, you were learning about get server-side props, get static props. You were learning about specific Next.js APIs that weren't available anywhere else. In this App Router world, in this new React server components world, you have a component, you mark it as async, you await some data. That's going to work the same way in Next.js, which is the first place that's implemented the App Router, and also future React frameworks that also implement these same primitives and these same features. And it's really just JavaScript. So this actually feels more React-y to me than doing something that's Next.js specific. Another comment here, the adoption of React Server Components has been hell for my app, and I've instead migrated to Remix. Remix has everything Next.js Pages Dir has, but upgraded, and also has more features that the app Dir has, like nested routes and layouts. I would look at Remix, and then some other comments around here. So the difference between Remix and Server Components, while there's lots of great things that Remix has done for the React community, like helping developers understand taking advantage of the server for more parts of their application, the concept of a loader in Remix, for example, is similar to a Git server-side props in Next.js Pages Router. So the flexibility of being able to mark a component as async and fetch some data with server components, that additive model to the React ecosystem isn't currently possible in the Remix world, although I'm sure they will be exploring that and implementing more of that in the future. But yeah, I mean, if you're using Remix and you're happy with it, that's totally fine as well too. Now, there's a bunch of other comments in this post, but there's one more I wanted to talk about, which is another reply from Shoddy Salamander, talking about how they're new to React and they spent a year learning and working in Create React App. So this sudden change in mental model with server components has been difficult for them. And I think this is something I can definitely empathize with. It's a new model. It's additive to this client-only world, and React's having more of an opinion about the server. So it's going to take a little bit of time for folks to try these things out, actually build applications with server components and see what these patterns look like in the real world. At the same time, you know, what I'm working on and others are working on is trying to provide more education, documentation, and guidance to make this process more smoothly. So if you're feeling intimidated or you're feeling like you want to stick with the Pages Router or the client-side only world today, that's totally okay. But we are hopefully going to try to make it as easy as possible to start learning about some of these new features and learn why server components are exciting and can help you make faster applications. There's a bunch more comments in the post, but I think we can probably end it here. If you want to see me do more videos like this, let me know. But hopefully this was helpful, and maybe this also made some things in your brain click for how the Next.js App Router or server components work. So stay tuned for the next video. Peace.